Martin?
What?
Felix is in the assembly.
What's this now?
Felix is in the assembly. They're ready to have you testify.
I don't want to talk.
Why are we in the municipality dying at a greater rate associated with COVID-19 than the people of the Matsu, where when we have the business killing mandates? In the Muni, you have in the Muni, 41 out of 100,000 have died related to COVID-19. In the Matsu, it's 27 out of 100,000. And they call the Matsu the Wild Wild West because it doesn't have any mandates. So I ask the Assembly and the esteemed advisors that help you, what's the goal and the end game? The goalposts are constantly being moved.
I know you believe you are saving our city with all these mandates, but what is actually happening is that you're killing it in other ways. I have a friend whose doctor visit was canceled when this pandemic happened because it was not an emergency. When he was finally able to be seen by a doctor months later, he found out he has cancer and is now fighting for his life.
I don't want to talk.
The original mandate passed by Berkowitz had allowances for disabled and those working with them. You have taken all of those out now and want to make it law. Some people with autism are sensitive to touch and texture. Covering the nose and face, covering the nose and mouth with fabric can cause sensory overload, feelings of panic, and extreme anxiety. But for my son, it's more than that. For my son, it's communication. His communication is very limited, and it is drastically inhibited by masks. I would ask you also if the deaf community has been affected by this mask mandate. With fewer than 1% of Americans having a confirmed case.
Apologies for interrupting, ma'am, but your time is up.
I don't want to talk.
And she's already seen that credibly occurring to other people who work in Anchorage School District, being derided, harassed, until they finally are forced to quit or are fired because of wrongthink.
Felix, I told you before you went with the Golden Lion, they're out there and they're going to recall you. And you seem to have been a real target because they got enough signatures and you're going to be recalled. The margin that you won by was narrow, and the activity they have politically, they'll get the votes. Felix, I want you to entertain the possibility of resigning and do it with honor and courage and sacrifice yourself for another day of leadership, because I think that could contribute to diffusing the anger for you personally rather than be recalled and get that stigma.
I've been following the Assembly actions and meetings for some time and decided that Tuesday, January 26, was to be my first live meeting. I'd seen some of the past videos and reports and wanted to see what was going on with my city leaders with my own eyes and hear it with my own ears. Some of the reports were hard to believe. What I saw was utterly disgusting. I saw a body of elected officials that, with a couple of notable exceptions, could not be bothered to take 30 minutes to genuinely listen to their constituents. A body of elected officials that had so little respect for their voters and what was being said that they fiddled with their phones, worked on laptops, and talked to each other. Some even left the room mid-testimony. How dare you? Who do you people think you are? Are you really that out of touch? I saw
that are being yelled at by bullies who now consider themselves the mass police. It is unthinkable. I witnessed a young girl being yelled at by an older man for not wearing her mask properly at the grocery store. You have empowered people to be bullies in this city.
I would like to call out the double standards this assembly is using. At the assembly meeting on December 8th, a member of this assembly, during official business, went on record after testimony of an Anchorage citizen and commented that he needs to be 86th. If you look up the definition for that phrase, you will find that it means to eliminate somebody, and that can mean to either remove him from the premises or it can mean to kill him. I do not know which of the two meanings this member had in mind because I didn't ask him. But if you use the same method of interpretation that you are using on Mrs. Allard's comments, which is to assume the worst, then you have to assume he publicly issued a death threat to a citizen of Anchorage.
Served your right to say the horrible things that you guys say. Through the chair, Mr. Rivera, I'm referring to some of the things Mr. Constant says. And so with my last few seconds, I would like to remind Mr. Constant that I remembered almost perfectly, but not perfectly, a regulation in our ordinances that I literally have not read for months. And yet he took an opportunity to impugn me by saying, and I quote, "This is the truth to these people." I didn't miss that implication, Constant.
I remember in June, during our five nights of testimony about the homeless shelters, on the very first night of testimony, the second testifier was the rabbi. And I remember sitting in silent disbelief and shock as Assembly Member Constant basically tried to back the rabbi into a corner using somebody else's email to say that the rabbi believed that the homeless should be rounded up and put behind a fence. It made national news. It was horrifying. It was atrocious to have an assembly member basically try to get a rabbi to say he was a Nazi. Oh my gosh, it was absolutely appalling.
The economic damage, business closures, social isolation, lack of quality education for our children, and suicides from loneliness, insomnia, stress, anxiety, anger, emotional exhaustion, and depression is what we need to be talking about. Not putting a useless mask on everyone and then eating up taxpayer dollars enforcing it.
Thank you for participating.